Торги Христі Христовчені, торги Христі брати і сестри. Слава Ісусу Христу! Владика Рихля був сином покійних вже батьків. Рейн і Анни Семенюки. Був він щирий, обожним хлопчиком. Мав за приклад його батьків. Якщо був молодим, він спілкувався зі своїми товаришами. Він грав на кларнеті, на саксофон і інколи під голим небом. Ми разом з усіма співали такі українські пісні. Бігом часу Рихль вступив до малої семінарії імені святого Василя Великопустим Горі. Тут далі він відбув свою духовну формацію. У тих руках він часто піду і вечері не вільно було говорити під час їдження, як було слухати Боже Слово. І відразу після того, хто читав духовну літературу, він щось вчився до святешного. На свято отець Рихль дозволив говорити і навіть ходити до сусіднього монастиря отців Афанасій, які працювали за церковну єдність, щоб глибити їх у знання нашої церкви, наших українських традицій, відправилися до літургії в англійській мові, очевидно, в тих роках задовжували пошлевитися. В тих роках не було бігло в нашій церкві справити до англійської. Коли скінчився тоді ті дні у семінарі і ті дні тривали більше років, Рихль з іншими поїхали до нашої української семінарі у Вахівкові пісні на богословській студії Cathedral. Отець Рихль з успішно скінчив ці студії, що тривали принаймні 4 роки в семінарі. До того Господь Бог благословив Владику Рихля багатьма талантами, між якими він здобув пайлет з лайсом і з'їхав рентованим тайпука по тілі його чоловіка природній цесті. І аж тоді митрополит Амфросій Синишин спізнав його як доброго священника. І він до Філадельфії, до нашої семінарії, він його висвятив на священника. Владика Рихль успішно став свій радий усьом. Митрополит у першому був у рік стане читача, а потім стане філіатом, а наприкінці на священника. У священстві мені працював довгі роки, аж до того часу, коли виринула потреба єпископа в Чикаго і Єцесі. За те, що в філадельфійській парку було занадто велика, і вибрали Владику Рихля, і його висвятили на єпископа. Та де ж мені жахали вас, і як уже послав мене отець, аз посилаю ви, ще у мір теж, і навчити вся язика, учати і вся, і лика заповідань вам. І ось це аз вами до скучання віка. Владика Рихля сумнівно, чесно і радісно виконував усе те, що Господь Бог йому наказав. І коли минулого тижня прийшов час залишити роботу тут на землі, закрив він твої очі і упокоївся у Божі. І, мабуть, він до Господа нашого архієрея говорив: я боровся Богом Божий, скінчив бік, вірус берів, і тепер же приготовлений для мене віном справедливості, що його дасть мені того дня Господь і справедливість судя. Та й не лише мені, але всім тим, що з тобою чекали на його появу. Ісус проповідає своїм священнослужителям: будьте вірні, вірний аж до смерті, а я тобі дам вінець життя. Рихль був вірний, служив Богові не тільки свою пасту, а голову Господа нашого Ісуса Христа. Амінь.
It is very beautiful. He gave testimony to Richard's gifts in music and musical instruments and his dedication to in becoming the priest that he's called to be as a priest. So we're very thankful to Bishop Robert Moskal for their sharing earlier at this time at the funeral for our beloved Bishop Richard Stephen. You know, it's interesting. Jesus called his disciples the salt of the earth. We heard it in the gospel today. And then to that high compliment, Jesus added a word of caution. He says, well, what if the salt goes flat? How can you restore its flavor? It's good for nothing. It's good enough only to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. And I want to borrow from that compliment today and apply it to our beloved departed Bishop Richard Stephen Seminack. Bishop Richard Stephen belonged in the company of those holy men and women that we can describe as the salt of the earth. And they never went flat. And I would add that it never went, not only did not go flat, it did not lose its flavor. Bishop Richard kept his zest for living to the end of life, even when facing declining health. He continued to persevere in his life vocation. And our world needs people like Bishop Richard. We miss them when they are gone. Their absence leaves a void. And those of us who remain have some obligation to try and emulate those things that we admired in him and appreciated in him. Are these characteristics true of us? Can we implant or enlarge them in ourselves in admiration for Bishop Richard Stephen? And what were some of these qualities that made Bishop Richard the salt of the earth and kept him that way throughout his life? Bishop Richard's life clearly reveals that he had a real deep sense of self-worth. He understood the importance of his earthly life. And he lived out of a deep sense of a meaningful purpose in life. Yet he was fulfilling God's divine mission within him. One of the most fascinating things about the ministry of Jesus is the way in which he infused ordinary people with a sense of self-worth. The first thing Jesus did for Simon, the brother of Andrew, was to give him a nickname, Peter. And it means the rock. And Simon spent the rest of his life trying to reach the implications of that nickname. One day Jesus met a woman of Samaria who for a long time had been thinking that her life did not matter. But after encountering Jesus, a strange thing happened. A miracle took place within her. She discovered that she was an important person and that the quality of her life did matter. It was important for her. Her life was important for her community. Her life mattered to God. And that same Jesus Christ would remind you and me today that who you are and what we do is extremely important. Every personality counts. There's a divine purpose for each of you here in this world. And we're called to live out of that sense of dedication to the God in that sense. Our departed Bishop Richard understood that about himself. He imparted that importance and giftedness of life to others. And we hear this so beautifully, so clearly in the many testimonies offered by former parishioners of his in the various parishes, particularly where Bishop Richard served as a pastor. Some articles in the newspaper shared comments from people who remarked on how approachable and how friendly Bishop Richard, Father Richard at that time, was to them, and how he had a way of lifting up them in their spirits, in their hope and joy in life. He listened to their concerns, he offered support, he offered counsel, but in a way that lifted the person to a higher sense of self-worth, celebrating life. Bishop Richard lived his life with a sense of mission and purpose, and he quietly inspired others to do the same thing. Quietly, he would listen to a long discussion, something, and then would hurl a few words right on, and would lift the situation. And that was one of the qualities that made him the salt of the earth. Another special quality of Bishop Richard was the way he handled challenges and difficulties in life. And he sure had his own challenges and burdens. Yet he showed such incredible strength in handling his life. He was not one to want to unnecessarily burden others with his own difficulties. He was always strong for others. He reached out to others in helping them carry their burdens and problems. And if Bishop Richard spoke of difficulties in his life, it was always generated with compassion for others, understanding, even for those who may have mistreated him or had been unkind to him. He was not one to hold a grudge. He forgave. He spoke no ill will about anyone else. When facing the challenges of declining health and illness, Bishop Richard valiantly embraced his suffering. Anyone who visited him during his stay in the hospital was blessed by the sense of his dedication of his own sufferings for others, particularly for his brother clergy and for the people he endeavored to serve. He did not feel sorry for himself. He entrusted himself to the Lord, knowing that there is a divine purpose in all things. Bishop Richard was the salt of the earth and was dealing with challenges in life. He demonstrated to each of us of how to entrust ourselves to God in His ways, to His ways in good times and in difficult times. And most important was Bishop Richard's steadfast faith in God. He lived and he professed profound faith in love and in God. He was blessed with good and holy parents who ensured that their children received a sound Catholic upbringing. How fondly he spoke of his parents. My time with him, more of his mother in his latter years, their contribution to his formation as a child of God. And when he spoke of his parents, his family always had a smile on his face. Always a grin. He enjoyed his visits to Philadelphia, he enjoyed his time with his family, and appreciated your support and your encouragement in his life and vocation to serve God as a priest and as a bishop. To journey with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is really the core of Bishop Richard's life. His almost 40 years of priesthood was characterized by ministry in a variety of ways. He served as a pastor in parishes within the Archeparchy of Philadelphia and then in St. Joseph at Eparchy of Parma when it was established. The faithful loved him and appreciated his pastoral, friendly, and gentle approach. He made time for everyone, listened and responded to the needs which presented themselves to him. And he also served as a chaplain to the Order of Sisters of St. Basil the Great, who are represented so beautifully today, as a chaplain in the United States Navy. He fulfilled many responsibilities in that new St. Joseph at Eparchy. Religious education, which was of special interest for him in his heart. As an Eparchy consultant, as an executive member of the Priest Pension Program, a chairman of the Diocesan Personnel Board, an Eparchy of Presbyterial Council, and in pastoral ministry. He was a priest to whom and with whom clergy of all ages developed trust and could turn to in time of need and counsel. He was also very hospitable to visiting clergy at his various parish assignments, and he was an exceptional pastor of souls and pastoral ministry. And these qualities, among others, led to his being named as a bishop of St. Nicholas of Eparchy in Chicago on March 25th, 2003. He was ordained by our previous patriarch, Bishop-emeritus, on June 4th, 2003. And like our Blessed Mother, who merely asked, how can this be? Bishop Richard also wondered about the challenge. Like the Blessed Mother, he gave his unconditional yes and humbly proceeded to offer his best. Bishop Richard showed great courage to undertake the mission entrusted to him, surrendering himself to the grace of God. And he continued to offer his gentle approach to address the needs of the priests and the parishes of the Chicago Eparchy. I recall how we shared discussions as to how quickly one learns that you cannot please everyone as a bishop. You cannot even fulfill the expectations you have of yourself. But with the grace of God, with hope and determinance, you move forward. I personally have held much admiration for Bishop Richard's stamina. He was aware of his own gifts and his own limitations better than anyone else. And unfortunately, some people make great efforts to remind him of his limitations. Yet, he patiently endured and just kept going. He was not a quitter, even with declining health. The episcopal responsibilities demanded much travel and sacrifice. His eparchy covered six or seven time zones in this nation, including all of most of Western, Central Western USA, and Alaska and Hawaii. I offered to take Hawaii as a grace, but he refused. Expectations demanded an ever-increasing detachment from his own will, requiring him to entrust himself to God's will for him. In his lifelong giving of himself in the service of the church which he loves so dearly, and to the Lord Jesus Christ whom he loved and dedicated himself to serve, Bishop Richard revealed to all who met him that he was truly the exposed who we can characterize as the salt of the earth. His light shined brightly before others, and his deeds gave glory to his Heavenly Father, as we heard in today's gospel. Our hearts are filled with gratitude to God for the gift of Bishop Richard. We understand he has entered his final healing. He is now with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, with whom he is no stranger. And we pray that God may bestow upon his soul that peace and unending joy which is beyond human understanding, and that is promised to all who love and serve the Lord. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Salve Jesus Christ.